So now we'll see some questions based on the trigonometry ratios we have studied, and also the question based on trigonometry ratios for specific angles. So first we'll write down the question and accordingly we'll see how to solve it. Is question is, in the given triangle AB is equal to 3 cm and AC is equal to 5 cm. Find all trigonometry ratios. So in this it is given that there is a triangle in which two sides are given. So accordingly we need to find out all trigonometric ratios. So definitely this triangle should be a right angle triangle, because we only deal with the right angle triangle in the trigonometry. So definitely this triangle is a right angle triangle. And in this AB is given as 3 and AC is given as 5. So accordingly first we'll find out BC. For finding out BC we'll use Pythagoras theorem, that is AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. So accordingly BC square is equal to AC square, that is 5 square, minus AB square, that is 3 square. So it will come as 16. So accordingly BC is equal to under root 16, that is 4 cm. So we got the value of BC as 4 cm. And now for finding out all trigonometry ratios, suppose we have taken this angle, let's say theta. So for finding out all trigonometry ratios, sine theta we can take as perpendicular, that is 3, upon hypotenuse, that is 5. This is sine theta. In the same way, cos theta will be equal to 4 by 5, that is base upon hypotenuse, and tan theta will be equal to perpendicular upon base, that is 3 by 4. In the same way, cosec theta will be equal to reciprocal of sine theta, that is 5 by 3. Sec theta will be equal to reciprocal of cos theta, that is 5 by 4, and cot theta will be equal to reciprocal of tan theta, that is 4 by 3. So in this way, we can solve the problem based on trigonometry ratios. Now we'll see one more example based on this. First I will write down the question is that if tan theta is equal to m upon n, then find sine theta. So in this it is given that tan theta is equal to m upon n, and we know that tan theta is equal to given as m by n, and we know that tan theta will be in the trigonometry ratio, tan theta will be equal to perpendicular upon base. So it means if we compare, we'll get the perpendicular as m and we'll get the base as n, and now we'll make the right angle triangle, and accordingly we need to find out the value of sine theta. So let's say suppose we have taken this as theta. So definitely this is perpendicular, that is m, and this is base, that is n. So accordingly we need to find out the hypotenuse for finding out the sine theta, because sine theta is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So AC square will be equal to m square plus n square. So accordingly AC will be equal to root m square plus n square. And now the value of sine theta will be equal to perpendicular, that is m, upon hypotenuse, that is root m square plus n square. So this is the value of sine theta. And if you need to find out any other trigonometry ratios apart from sine theta also, we can also find using this method. So in this way we can use the trigonometry ratios. Now a few more examples we'll see. So first we'll write down the question is, if cosec A is equal to 13 by 5, then prove that tan square A minus sine square A is equal to sine 4A into sec square A. So in this it is given that cosec A is equal to 13 by 5, and accordingly we need to prove this, that is in the LHS part, tan square A minus sine square A will be equal to the RHS, that is sec sine 4A into sec square. So accordingly first we'll make the right angle triangle, and accordingly we'll see what is given in the question. So suppose we'll take this as A, this is B, and this is C. So as it is given that cosec A, that is this angle is given, cosec A is equal to 13 by 5. So as you know that cosec theta is actually the reciprocal of sine theta, and sine theta is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So cosec theta will be hypotenuse upon perpendicular. So hypotenuse upon perpendicular means if you compare it like cosec A, as it is given as 13/5, so that will be equal to hypotenuse upon perpendicular. So hypotenuse will be 13 and perpendicular will be 5. So hypotenuse is 13 and perpendicular is 5. So accordingly AB is, we get as 12 by using the Pythagoras theorem, because AC square is equal to BC square plus AB square, and accordingly we will get AB square is equal to 13 square minus 5 square, that is 169 minus 25, that is 144, and accordingly AB will be equal to root 144, that is 12 centimeter. Now we got this, that is we got the base of the triangle. Now we need to prove that LHS will be equal to RHS. So as you know that our LHS part will be equal to 10 square A minus sine square A. So as you know, 10 A is actually perpendicular upon base. So that is 5 upon 12 and whole square, because square is there, minus sine A is perpendicular, that is 5 upon hypotenuse, that is 13 whole square. So that will be equal to, if you simplify it, you will get as 25/144 minus 25/169. Now accordingly if you simplify, what you will get is, after simplifying, you will get, first there you will need to find out the LCM, that is 144 into 169, and accordingly you will take common 25 common from the numerator, you will get 169 minus 144. So this will be equal to 25 into 25 upon 144 into 169. So this thing you will got in LHS. Now we'll see whether we get the same thing in the RHS or not. If we get the same thing, then it means LHS will be equal to RHS. So our RHS is given as sine 4a into sec square a. So sine a will be equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse, that is 5 upon 13 raised to the power 4 into sec square a. So sec a is actually the reciprocal of cos a, and cos a is base upon hypotenuse. Sec a is hypotenuse upon base, that is 13/12 whole square. So accordingly if we simplify it, we will get 5 raised to the power 4 upon 13 raised to the power 4 into 13 square upon 12 square. So accordingly if we cancel this 13 square with 13 raised to the power 4, it will become 13 square. So 25 raised to the power 4 means 25 into 25 upon 13 square, 12 square is 144 and 13 square is 169. It means we got the same thing in the RHS part also. So this shows that our LHS is equal to RHS, hence proved. So in this way we can use this trigonometry ratios for solving many questions. So now we'll see one few more example based on these trigonometry ratios. So first we'll write down the question, that is, in triangle ABC, right angled at B, AC plus AB is equal to 9 and BC is equal to 3 cm. This is given, 9 cm and 3 cm. Determine the value of cot C, cosec C and sec C. So in this question it is given that there is a right angle triangle, right angled at B, that is 90 degree is forming at angle B. First we'll make the right angle triangle. So this is our angle B. So when suppose we'll take it as A and this will take it as C. So it is given that BC is 3 cm and AC plus AB, that is the sum of other two sides, is given as 9 cm. So accordingly if we take AB as X, AC will become 9 minus X. So now we'll find out the value of X by using Pythagoras theorem. That is 9 minus X whole square is equal to AB square, that is X square, plus BC square, that is 3 square. Now we'll simplify it, we'll get as 81 plus x square minus 18x is equal to x square plus 9. So x square and x square will get cancelled. So we'll take 9 in the LHS part and minus 18x in the RHS part. So 81 minus 9 is 72 is equal to 18x, so x will be equal to 72 by 18, that is 4 cm. It means our one of the side is 4 cm and other side is 9 minus x, that is 9 minus 4, that is 5 cm. So it means we got the other two sides, and now we have to find out, or we have to determine the value of cot c. So as we know that cot c is actually the reciprocal of tan c. So accordingly, as we know that tan c, as we have taken this angle c, so tan c is actually perpendicular upon base. So cot c is base upon perpendicular. So that is 3. So base will become 3 and perpendicular is 4. So cot c is 3 by 4. In the same way, cosec c will be equal to is the reciprocal of sin c. Sin c is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So cosec c is hypotenuse upon perpendicular. That is 5 by 4. This is our cosec c. In the same way, we need to determine sec c. So sec c is reciprocal of cos c. Cos c is base upon hypotenuse. So sec c is hypotenuse, that is 5, upon base, that is 3. So in this way, we actually understood the question properly. We first have to make the diagram properly, and then we can easily determine the value of any trigonometry ratios that is asked in the question. And now we'll see one more question based on this trigonometry ratios. First we'll write down the question is, given that cos a minus b is equal to cos a into cos b plus sin a into sin b. This is the relationship between cos a minus b, cos a, cos b, sin a and sin b. And accordingly, we need to find the value of cos 15. So now we need to find out the value of cos 15 degree. As we have studied trigonometry table, we have not studied the value of cos 15. So for finding out the value of cos 15, what we can do is, we can write cos 15 as cos 45 minus 30. Why we have taken cos 45 minus 30 is because we have studied the value of cos 45, cos 30, sin 45 and sin 30. So accordingly, we have taken it as cos 45 minus 30. Or if we want, we can also take it as cos 60 minus 45. That is also cos 15. So any of these two things we can take. So let's say we'll take cos 15 as cos 45 minus 30. That is cos 15 same. So it's actually in the form of cos a minus b, which is given in the question. That is cos a minus b. So that is cos 45 minus 30. And cos a minus b is cos a into cos b. That is cos 45 into cos 30 plus sin a into sin b. That is sin 45 into sin 30. So this will become our cos 15. And now, as we already knows the value of cos 45, cos 30, sin 45 and sin 30. So we'll keep those value here, and accordingly we'll get the value of cos 15. So cos 45 we know as 1 by root 2 into cos 30 we know as root 3 by 2 plus sin 45 we know as 1 by root 2 into sin 30 we know as 1 by 2. So accordingly, if we simplify it, we'll get root 3 by 2 root 2 plus 1 by 2 root 2. So their denominator is same, so LCM will also be same, that is 2 root 2. So numerator will become root 3 plus 1. So this is the value of our cos 15. So cos 15 is equal to root 3 plus 1 upon 2 root 2. So in this way, by using the trigonometry ratios, we can find out by using the trigonometry table or using the trigonometry ratios for specific angles, that is 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90, we can find out many other things in the trigonometry, or many other trigonometry ratios. Like in this question, we have found out the value of cos 15 by using the value of cos 45, cos 30, sin 45, sin 30. That is the table which we have studied. So using that table, we have solved this question very easily. So this, in this way, we can solve many questions based on this trigonometry ratios.